Good morning, y'all. Today's gonna be a busy day, but a busy day in a good way. I'm just doing a bunch of like Christmassy shopping. This is probably the last time y'all are gonna see Mr. Ghost this season. I'm ready to bring on Christmas. Jen Coolidge. I love how she's having a renaissance, but really, she's just been an icon my entire life. Okay, kids, we just dropped off Bug. I need to tell y'all that I was talking to Chris yesterday. I can't remember if I mentioned this in a video, but I am like so ready and so excited for Christmas. Like, I just have no interest in Halloween or fall. Like, I'm excited for Thanksgiving, but it's more for like the cooking factor of Thanksgiving and not really like the fallness. I'm very much ready for Christmas and the winter holidays. And I told Chris last night, I was like, I just want to, my Halloween plans are to watch Christmas movies. And then he's like, I'm surprised you haven't started decorating for Christmas already. And I was like, yeah, but I don't want to like overdo it. And you live here too, so I don't want to just decorate the apartment for Christmas and maybe you're not in the mood for Christmas. And I'm pretty sure I got the green light to decorate for Christmas early. So with that in mind, last night as I was scrolling through Pinterest, I stumbled across a gingerbread collection that Pottery Barn has, and I was like, oh my god, I love it, I need it, I want some more of it. We are heading to Grand Avenue, which is so stinking cute. If you guys are in Minnesota, in the Twin Cities, come to St. Paul. First off, St. Paul is a beautiful city. Secondly, there's Summit Avenue, which is the longest stretch of Victorian houses in the country. Gorgeous. Right, like, block parallel to Summit is Grand Avenue. And Grand Avenue just has, like, the cutest little shops and stuff. Anyways, let's go shopping. Thank you.
some shopping today, and I thought I'd share that little haul with y'all. It's kind of a mixture of like things I need now and things I need in the future. So let's just start with the thing that's on top. As y'all saw, I went to Paper Source. So from Paper Source, I got this cute little North Pole newspaper wrapping paper. I wanted to do newspapers, but sometimes, you know, the actual newspaper can be a little bit of a bummer and a downer, and I just didn't want any potential bummer stuff to be as wrapping papers. I was wandering around Paper Source and found this. I was like, oh my god, this is exactly what I was looking for. I was actually like super excited. I went to Pottery Barn because they currently have a gingerbread set that's out. Now, the gingerbread set has like a bunch of different pieces, but the main piece I wanted was this gingerbread house platter. That's what this is. It's slightly odd shaped, but that would be really cute for like cookies and treats and stuff like that. I thought it was cute, a little different. And then also these iced gingerbread mugs.
Oh god.
Y'all, they're so cute. Comes in a set of two. This was a set of two for $29. The other one is different, so they aren't the same, which is kind of cute. How stinking cute are those? But the lady at Pottery Barn was definitely trying to sell me on like pretty much the entire set, and I was like, I don't need the entire set. There was some pieces I was like, oh, that's really cute, but she was showing me like little nameplate holder, like the little gingerbread houses that were nameplate holders, and I'm like, I'm not hosting any formal parties. I just want like a cute platter and maybe a couple cute mugs. And then I went to this one store called Golden Fig, and they sell kind of a little hodgepodge of everything. It's kind of like an artisan little food market, and they have just like the cutest stuff ever. I got some hot chocolate for my gift exchange person. And then I also got mixers that you can buy, and this is their autumn elixir. And I thought this would be really good with like a bourbon or a whiskey, or even just mixed with like an apple cider. So that was from Golden Fig. And then finally, this is what I got from Walmart. This was my reason for going to Walmart. I finally got a matching pot and pan set. So I'm very excited for this, and I can't wait to get rid of all of our pots and pans. That's today's haul. I hope you guys like checking out Grand Avenue with me. There's definitely a lot more on Grand Avenue, but it's like, it's in chunks. So that was kind of like the Victoria Crossings area we were in today. So it's really like chunked out because there is a lot of residential apartments along Grand as well. So it's not a giant strip of just shopping, as much as I would love that. System. I think it would be the perfect size. Okay, y'all. We were just in HomeGoods and I started filming everything, and then I was gonna continue filming, but I was literally just looking at Christmas stuff. I don't want a Christmas overload quite yet, just because not everyone is in the Christmas spirit, but it was kind of, I don't know, almost, I feel like everyone else is on the same page because there was a lot of Halloween stuff still on the shelves. I think everyone's ready for Christmas. I will say though, there was a really cute blanket that I was like, this close to getting, and I didn't get it because it was just really, it was basic in the sense that it didn't have a fringe or any tassels, and it was just like a knit blanket. I don't know, a part of me was just like, if it just had like tassels,
just even like on the four corners, it would just be like perfect. I'm about to go to Taco John's and get some potato olays, okay? Okay, bud.
Yeah, no worries. Can I get a 6-pack and a pound, half and half? And then can I also do one of your guys' beefy loaded cheddar tacos? Yep, perfect. And that should be it. Thank you.
We have secured the goods. Oh, yeah.
So this morning I did something a little different. I set my coffee to start brewing before I took these little cutie patooties outside. When I walked in, y'all, I forgot how much I appreciate the smell of freshly brewed coffee in the morning because it just smelled so good. And I feel like when I'm actually making it, I don't really smell it because I just like, I'm there as it's doing the process. But this morning, just like being outside, and then walking in from outside to inside and to place smelling like coffee, it was such a treat, such a treat. So I definitely think I'm gonna start doing that more, especially with the colder months starting to creep up on us. I just wanted to kind of show y'all what I got yesterday. I went to Home Goods and bought a couple things. I actually was pretty good. I did put quite a few things back. There's probably a couple candles that I put back. Oh yeah, that, there was a clip of it. The blanket, a part of me kind of wishes I had kept that. Yeah, it was just a little too plain. Like it needed either a fringe or a tassel. Honestly, I said tassels yesterday, but preferably a fringe. Anywho, with that said, let's go through what I got. To start, ice cube trays. I was actually gonna get normal sized ice cubes, but the only color option was the bottoms were teal. I like the color teal, but I'm really trying to get stuff that's like within this color scope I want so that I'm not just buying random shit. Right, Jinx. So if it was like black or if it was gray or if it was white, if it was anything in those areas. Next, I got a glass wood container. These kind of containers I use to put in my like flour, sugar, brown sugar, all that stuff. Oh, y'all. Okay, these were so cute. During the holiday season, I actually recently, in the past 2 years or so, have really enjoyed making brie because I go through phases where I really like making charcuterie boards and I feel like just warm brie is really great to have with a solid charcuterie board. So I got a brie cheese baker. They actually had a bunch of different options. A lot of them, the little topper bit right here was seasonally themed. I wanted something that wasn't just specific to Christmas. I wanted something that I could use whenever. I was like in a section where it was like Christmas, 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 and then it was just this guy. Just plain little white knob. Perfect. I was about to get the deer, but I think this will be just perfect. Next, I got, this is technically a table runner. We don't really have the type of table where you need a table runner, but we do have a pretty long entertainment unit. I thought this would be really cute to put across the entertainment unit. So this is a Pecksniff's candle. Y'all, a couple of vlogs ago, I was going off about Pecksniff and Olivia Blake candles, and I found this one called Bourbon and Mandarin. And it just smells so, so lovely. And it's a big boy. It's a big candle. It's like you could burn this any time of year, but it definitely has kind of the perfect, like warm, cozy winter vibes too. This is a good transitional candle, either between Thanksgiving. This would be a good Thanksgiving candle, actually. I found these Bear Paw socks. They are so soft. Perfect, just keep my feet from not being naked during the winter. So squishy and just kind of really simple neutral colors. Finally, I was in the food section and there was like a bunch of peppermint bits and dust and whatever. So this is peppermint dust. I just thought this would be perfect for cocoa, for holiday baking, for a bunch of different things. And a part of me was like, well, Kayla, do you really need to buy peppermint dust for $5? Yes, I do. And I'll tell you my reasoning behind this, because I have done many of bakings that call for crushed up mint stuff. And then you have to go through the process of shattering them all. And even then, they're really usually chunky. Like, I've never been able to get mine to like a nice fine dusty powder like this. So I was like, this is gonna make life so much easier. So I did get some peppermint dust for holiday baking. That is my little home goods haul. Again, I didn't want to go too overboard on Christmas stuff, but y'all, there were so many cute Christmas items that I can't stop thinking about. And I might have to go back next weekend. If it's still there next weekend, it was meant to be. But yeah, the Vikings play today. Let's see how they do. We're gonna probably wrap up the vlog here. I know it's Thursday and typically I do wrap things up on Friday, but I don't foresee anything wild and crazy happening tomorrow. I do have an adventure for this weekend though, so that'll be next week's vlog. And this adventure contains me finding a very specific style Christmas cup. I have a hunch that there is a thrift store in Minneapolis that has this kind of mug. I'm gonna take y'all there. It's gonna be a good time. Whether we find what we're looking for or not, definitely gonna find a bunch of stuff there. And yeah, just get ready. The vlogs are gonna be containing a lot more Christmassy stuff because that just is the road I'm going down right now. I'm just holding on to my Earl Grey as it brews for the morning. Y'all, I will say though, I am a little bummed. I saw it coming from a mile away. It rained last night and majority of the fall leaves have come down with the rain. Those that aren't are probably gonna be gone by the beginning of next week because we're supposed to get like 3 days in a row of just raining, and then it's supposed to just be cold. Starting I think Tuesday, it's supposed to be cold. So when I say cold, it's gonna be in like the 30s/40s starting next week. So brace yourself, Minnesota. Winter is coming. I am very excited about that. So I apologize for anyone who just isn't on the Christmas Express like I am. This vlog is coming out in slightly seasonally timely fashion because this vlog is coming out November 1st. So Halloween has technically already come and gone for you. With that, y'all, I should probably get ready for the day. I'll see you next week at the thrift store. Okay, bye!